survive.
Rafting could be such an addictive sport, and it's almost like taking drugs because you have a great fear of going into a rapid or something, and then you end up doing okay and coming out okay, and you live and you get endorphins.
Here is the famous man from Normandy.
Marmando!
Clear water, blue skies, check the fish coming. And the middle fork of the salmon.
Extraordinaire. So he's not stuck.
No, he's parked in the hole.
Not much of an eddy, huh?
Well, you know, it's an adequate eddy.
Uh-huh.
If somebody comes around that bend not knowing that you're supposed to get out of the rapids, then, you know.
Right, because it's halfway through the rapids.
Yeah.
If you miss it, it's not a good thing.
If you miss the eddy, you're going to hike the gear up.
But it will be tight in there, and you're just going to be in the center, and then the current's going to all go right, and then you just take a few backstrokes and pull back. But don't, it's not the end of the world if you hit it, you know.
Okay.
It's like a lot of people at this water level will have their nose hit the rock. You always ran right at center.
Were you scared?
No.
But you were surprised.
You know, sometimes, and there's another time when I actually got a feeling of euphoria where I hit the line, and sometimes it's kind of embarrassing because there's the rest of the rapid that you have to run. And if you're blissed out, it's sometimes hard to concentrate on the rest of the rapid.
Yeah, and now that seems to have rolled someplace or another. It's not there.
Okay, smile, dear. Act natural.
Yay!
Here's Jim and Joanne bookiting.
Bookiting.
Doing what?
Bookiting the boat. We put the bookets in the boat.
The bookets in the boat.
He got tired. What's the name of this camp? Do you guys know the name of this camp? I'm documenting.
Higher grouse, lower grouse?
Lower grouse camp.
Water from that,
yeah.
Dripping on the back of your neck.
Yeah, that's good.
Like a moment of enlightenment and you want to hold on to it.
Exactly.
I thought your run was excellent. You'll be able to see it all on video.
Excellent.
Is this camp?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, you do.
1/12 of it.
I want my royal
name. I think there's where we're talking, because this is a valuable.
I'm not going to be like those guys in Gilligan's Island who never got paid after 9,000 reruns.
It's a special moment in history.
Stepping up to the proverbial plate.
Two big balls, if you don't think that's enough.
I got two, okay, cool. One for each arm.
Mighty fine root stew!
It will put a big...
A cherry cobbler?
Mm-hmm. Randy made some awesome cherry cobbler.
But let's look and see who's first in line.
Don't take all of it.
I'm gonna try not to, but it will be difficult.
Look at the line. Look at the line of clamorers.
Line of clamorers.
Dessert clamorers. Dutch.
I didn't time it very good.
Came out perfect.
What would you rate this? I guess we'll have to wait till you taste it.
Well, presentation would be a 10.
10, right?
Yeah.
How is it? tastes good.
It's delicious. It's wonderful.
How is it, ladies?
Somebody liked it.
Did we use the
pot? Hot.
Peter is going in for second.
No info.
And he's shameless about it. Just have it all.
No. That would be bad.
Would it be bad? How come?
I don't know. Because you'd want to share with your campmate friends a little bit.
Oh, look who's here.
Look who is here.
Okay, you gotta share that.
Is this number two? No, this is my first.
Yeah, no, he's so lying.
Well, Norm was right back to me.
Well, don't take all the juicy parts. He needs some.
Okay. Peter's
he didn't eat his broccoli. Oh, so you shouldn't get your second. No dessert for those who don't eat broccoli.
No, try it.
Your wife ate it. Whoops. Good to the last drop. Check it out. Randy. I think you should have made two. No, I would take it, but oh. Yeah.
I was afraid it was from
Oklahoma for banana. Bananas.
Bananas. Guy from Oklahoma.
Walked into the store and said, I like some taters, some maters, and some nanners, please. So I said, you're from Oklahoma, aren't you? He goes, shoot, you can tell that just from the way I talk. I said, well, that, in fact, this is a hardware store.
And we've been really good today because we haven't even brought up that trip. Can you quickly, briefly explain the system?
Explain the system.
The system is first you sit down
if we
and
don't
eat.
Wash the dishes, we won't have clean dishes tomorrow.
And so, the first bucket is the grunge bucket. That's where all the nasty...
I'm in the grunge.
You are in the grunge.
Grunge.
That's my favorite part.
So Mr. Lewis here is doing the grunge. This is the wash bucket. And then the dishes go into the rinse bucket. And then from there, they go to the Clorox bucket.
The all-important Clorox bucket.
Let's sit for a moment. And it's always handy to have three people to help you with the dishes, because then the fourth person, third person, can always take the rinse.
Would you like mommy to help you?
Dishes. Oh, well, that would be wonderful.
Okay.
It would.
Nice view from up here, isn't it?
Sure is.
heading
gotta
out.
Gotta get out there. Oh, you were out there already. This is really where the beauty is everywhere.
The way we went, they had these roots there. Not able to read our minds. No, we wasn't.
The record of how many Cocopelli girls he got. A little notch for everyone.
Wow. This is the Apache keeping range. There's nothing there except in the very middle we'll find one artifact, like a big chopper or, you know, a big stone artifact.
As I mean, in our society you'd say it was as his child, but right. Those societies don't operate that way. If something happens to him, like he dies, right, you have all of these other men who could make the mental case that it's really theirs.
But he may be a big hunter. Look how big he is. He's a big hunter.
You can probably figure that one out.
He's a big hunter.
Yeah, look how big he is.
And
well, what's he hunting?
Probably mountain
sheep. Oh, he's, well, it's a symbol
he may be.
To show that he's a good hunter and he can give your child that skill.
Look at how many he's delivered. Look at how many he's delivered. Those are probably count of kids, and these are probably count of sheep. I don't know about the color. The color will change.
And
what is this pigment?
It looks like red ochre.
And where does
it's a very bright,
soft mineral that you can.
So is it like a clay-like thing?
No, more like salt.
Maybe these are people's legs.
And keeps breaking down.
Yeah,
and
that's
if you
gotta
get
be
some,
it.
You find.
Jim, what's your explanation
for all the dashes? Okay. These are all the women that he made whoopee with.
That's exactly what Andy said.
Well, it could be potential children.
But I'm like, oh well, I'm not gonna pay you anymore because you're not telling us what we want.
So these are what I was looking at, Howard.
Well, but they're.
I think they're really old.
Yeah, they're old.
I think these are just water collection.
This water bucket.
Water's pockets collected over here.
Or it's coming down and etching away.
So nice.
You're the only one that likes people.
It's called Cold Springs Creek.
What do you mean it's certified?
He's certified by Mike.
He's joking.
But I'll tell you one thing, it's the coldest water you can find down here. It's really good, isn't it?
It's certified by a genuine Idahoan. So Mike Idahoan. Says this is drinkable? Well, that shows it must be drinkable.
He heard it on the
certified
internet.
Certified clear wet water.
Anything yeah. Mike says goes, as far as I'm concerned.
One thing, it's
Mike's
nice.
Like a demigod.
Maybe safe for drinking.
Or a demigod.
Yeah, safe for drinking.
Maybe.
It is one thing, it's nice and cold for your water.
May be safe for drinking.
Drink at your own risk.
paddle as hard as you can.
And having a blade in the water also helps tremendously with your paddle. Tremendously.
He found out I was sneaking up on him.
Stock, Chun stock.
Just need two little sticks.
How much longer you guys think you'd be with this trailer?